Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. In today's tutorial, I will show you how you can create a SwiftUI modifier in UIkit, of course in Swift 5. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, SwiftUI is all the craze, and the most stunning or eye-catching part of it is this dot syntax. Well, these are called modifiers and they are chained to each other. So let's replay this. You just type in turtle rock and add dot font, dot title, dot color, dot green. Now the modifier is dot font and the dot title is of course the property. We are going to build out this today with in UIkit with the help of Discardable. So let's jump right into it and let's create a new Xcode project. So go to new project and you could create any old type of Xcode project. Just make sure it's Swift, and I will name this SwiftUI modifiers in UIkit. Okay, sounds good. Let's click on next and I will drag and drop it here. Six. Let's create it and let's create a new folder entitled code. There we go. And I will make sure that create Git repository on my Mac is checked, so you can take a look at it on my GitHub page. So let's create it. Yes, there we go. And let's see. Let's go and select our root view controller here. And what we usually do, and again, let me just bring up the browser here. We want to create a text with a font and a color. So we are going to create a UI label with a font and a color. So let's see here. What we usually do is create a lazy var. Let's say label, and it is a UI label. And we just initialize it. And yeah, let's just declare it here. So let label equals UI label and let's return it. So what we usually do here is add in here label and font equals UI font dot, let's say system font of size 14 and label dot and text color equals, let's say dot, I don't know, maybe red so we can see it. Okay, and yeah, that is how we usually initialize it. Let's return our label and yeah, let us just have our views background color. So background color equals dot white so we can see this, and let's add our label. So view dot add subview and label. Okay, and maybe let's import tiny constraints real quick so we can center it to the screen real easy. So let's close this. Let's navigate to our root folder real quick. And I believe you already know the drill. Open up terminal, type in cd and a space, just drag and drop it there, hit return, pod init. I'm just going through this real fast. So yeah, you already know how to do this. Okay, let's have platform iOS 12 and pod tiny constraints. There we go, with capital C. pod install. Oh, sorry about that. Pod install. And now we can open up our Xcode project from the workspace. Okay. And yeah, now we can simply center it into our super view. So that is how easy it is to basically add tiny constraints to your app. And if you are interested in tiny constraints and how you can use it, there is a whole playlist explaining everything about tiny constraints on my channel. So label and let's see, center in super view. So now we can select one of our simulators, and Tenor is one of my favorites, I believe. I don't know, it's kind of down there, and I really like it. So let's see, what do we have here? Well, it's cannot find the tiny constraints module, but it will, as you can see, build has succeeded, and yeah, we don't see anything because we don't have any text in it, but we will do that just now. So let's add in here a label.text equals, and I believe it was Turtle Rock, if I'm correct. Let's see if I'm correct. Yes, Turtle Rock. There we go. And now we can hit Command R and build and run our project. So there we go, Turtle Rock. And I will set this to black so we can start off with what this example starts off. So let's replay this. As you can see, hello Swift UI, and here we have Turtle Rock. The font will be title and the color will be green. Okay, let's switch back to our Xcode project. And first of all, we kind of want to have this functionality because, yeah, changing the size of the font and its color, it's quite easy. Once we have our discardable result UI view, or rather that in our case UI label extension. So let's create our extension here. Okay, here comes the fun part. So extension. And we are going to extend our UI label, and we are going to create an at discardable result function. And if you want to add this to a CocoaPod library like I did, then you have to set this to public at least, or maybe open. So let's see here, what do we want to have? Font. Okay, so we just type in font here. And this will have a font property, and it will be of type UI font. And here comes the interesting part, and I will explain in just a moment what this means. You want to return a UI label, and let's return self, because this is an extension. The self is the actual UI label. So this discardable result basically means, I already have a YouTube video on this, but I will jump on it real short. It either returns a UI label, or, well, it returns a UI label, but you can use it or not. It depends on your case. And if we go back here to our example, the Turtle Rock font, so the font modifier has return value, and in this case with SwiftUI it's a view, but in our case it will be a UI label, so we can chain the next modifier, the color, to it. But after the color we don't have anything to add here, but it still returns a UI label, or it will return a UI label, but it doesn't complain that, okay, we return a UI label. What do you want to do with it? Do you want to store it in a variable or a constant or anything like that? So that's why discardable result is so powerful. Okay, so let's just learn how this works. So we want to, or rather yet, let's just create all of, maybe let's create the text here. So Let's see, it's pretty simple. So text, and it will be of type string, and we just return self again. Now we want to add that text basically. So what we want to do is call on self.text, because of course UI label has a text value, and that will be our text. And maybe because this is an optional, so let's double check if really it is an optional. Yes, it is here, as you can see. We might as well get this string to be an optional too. So how do we add this? Well, it is pretty straightforward. Let's just delete this and add this dot here, and you can see that we have a text. And of course this is the basic UIkit property text, but here we have returning a UI label. And let's add in here our turtle rock string, and yeah, that will return basically the same thing. Okay, next up is the font. So once we take a look at the build and run, there we go, looks really nice. Let's take a look at the font, and it's kind of the same. So let's see here, self.font, and let's just add in here our font. How awesome is that? So let's just change this to system font of size 14. So how do we handle that? Okay, font, and now we have something that is returning a UI label. So font will be dot system font of size 14, and that should compile real easily. Okay, let's see here, real awesome. Now here comes the really fun part, the chaining of these modifiers. So let's say I just want to get rid of this line. I don't want to have all of these one after the other, or one line after the other. I want to change this. So let's comment this out, and after we added our text property, let's add our font here, and the same system font of size 14. How awesome is that? Okay, let's just build and run so you can see that it really builds, it compiles, and it does basically the same thing. Okay, now what we want to do here is, well, let's bump up the font size. Well, you could have this as a modified, like title or subtitle. We could have here, and there we go, it's much larger. But yeah, that is inside of a Duck UI that basically has these chainable modifiers. If you are interested in, go ahead and take a look at it, download it and play around with it. I will create a separate playlist on the channel detailing everything. Well, Duck UI is basically Swift UI for UIkit, kind of. Okay, let's go back to our project now. And finally, let's take a look at the text color. So yeah, again, another copy and paste here. And let's see, text, and I will add in here color. There we go. And self dot, and I believe it is text color. Okay, so text color equals color. And in our case, we don't really need to have self here, because yeah, before I explain that, let me just change this to color. So we don't really need to have self here, because text color is not the color that we added here near the name of the property. So let me just delete that. Here we just infer the font property of our UI label with self, of course, because font is the same characters, of course. So let's do that, and let's just change this here. So font color, or text color rather, yet text color, there we go, and it is dot green. There we go, let's comment this out and build and run to see the changes. Okay, turtle rock, real nice. And of course, if we wanted to, we can just let's hit Command X here to delete all of this and copy it into our pasteboard. And we just simply, let's see here, let's add everything down here. It's the same. And just to keep it Swift UI like, let's just add in here these new lines of code, and it looks really, really awesome. And while we are at it, let me just remove everything here so we can add just a simple label declaration. And again, let's take a look. Label.text, turtlerock.font, system font of size 24. Of course, this can be added with some enums. So yeah, it is available in DocUI. And text color, green. Now we can have text font or other stuff, but yeah, let me just show you side by side how that looks. So font, color, maybe we should change it to color. I don't really mind. Let me just do that real quick. Let's see. Color and color. Okay, let's hit Command R one final time and see how you learn how to use SwiftUI modifiers basically in UIkit. Now that is it for me today. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell, because even if you subscribe and you don't hit the notification bell, you might miss out on some of the new videos as they do come out, and I don't want you to miss any new videos. I put out new videos daily, so yeah, hit that notification bell. And as always, I will see you in the next one.